process that we used for the ChroMath was we began with a very simple box model in Maya that was built in a neutral pose, and from there we began sculpting in ZBrush, creating the basic shapes and forms of the ChroMath. Once we had that established, we used Transpose to pose the tool, and then we continued detailing and working the primary and secondary forms as they would deform over the pose that the ChroMath is in. We would also subdivide up to about 4 million polygons and go in and detail the skin. The armor elements were created in Maya. Those were just regular polygon models that we output as OBJs, brought into ZBrush, and then created the surface detailing that you see, the weathered texture on the armor itself. The armor parts were output one piece at a time on the rapid prototyping machine. The pieces that you see on the ChroMath are directly from the output. We didn't actually mold those. Those are straight off the machine, painted in the paint department, and then applied to the character. The ChroMath itself, the body, was too large for a single rapid prototyping machine. So we took the pieces, we cut him apart digitally. We took his arms and legs and separated them from his body, and the head was separated from the trunk. The arms and legs were output on a rapid prototyping machine, as was the head. The body was too large for the rapid prototyping tray, so we had that foam milled. And each of those pieces was then molded in silicone and then cast in Chavant. Chavant is a prototyping clay which has no sulfur, so you can actually melt it down to a liquid and then pour it into a mold. So we ended up with clay duplicates of each limb and the head and trunk of the original Z-Tool. Those were then reassembled and the transitions retooled. We fixed up any areas where we lost detail and then took another mold of the entire character and silicone, and then we cast that again, but this time we cast it in a two-part resin, a hard plastic. So the ChroMath body is a solid hunk of resin, whereas the armor is plastic directly off the rapid prototyping machine. And everything was painted in-house at Gentle Giant in our paint department, and the leather and trim was added as well.